Hi guys, so it's New Year's. Happy New Year's, everyone. And I am getting ready to go to a family member's house. I should do like this so you can see what I did. This is the eye that I did. And this is what I'm going to show you. I've already done my foundation, which if you want to see that, go ahead and look at one of the other videos. Maybe it's on this side. And I have about my foundation routine. So let's get right into it. I've already used my shadow insurance and I've taped off my eye as well. So the first thing that you're going to be using, you're going to use your NYX Jumbo Pencil and Milk. And put that all over the eye. My hair is pinned up. It's not the way I'm going to just wear it. I'm just getting that on because along with the primer, it also helps to adhere. So another thing that I'm going to use is another jumbo pencil, and it's by Ruby Kisses, and it's this really nice blue color, and it rolls up and down. I'm just going to put that all over my lower lid. And this is like another liquid, so switch fingers up when you're blending it, or if you're blending it with a brush, do that. But I find my finger is the best blending tool. The best makeup artists use their finger along with brushes. Too much in the corner. Okay, so now that that is set, I'm going to go into my Wet n Wild palette, and I'm going to pick this shimmery color here on this side. Remove that light because you can't really get the good color. There we go. Okay. Just using a regular applicator. Oh Lord, did I go on the wrong eye? Yes. You guys can see that. Almost messed up a perfectly good eye. So I'm just gonna layer this. This is basically being layered over that NYX Jumbo Pencil and Milk. It's gonna help with my with my highlight. So what I'm laying first before I put some foundation, some eyeshadow over this blue. Okay, so next I'm gonna go back into that palette and I'm gonna pick the blue on the matte side. Just press it on. It's a perfect match for this jumbo pencil, and then basically I use my finger to make sure it adheres. You can feel where it's extra sticky, that's where you need to go ahead and adhere it. It's like a pressed powder. Okay, perfect. Now I'm going to go into another eyeshadow that I actually picked up at a kiosk in Southland Mall. And it is called Mika Bella. Comes like this. It's a shimmer powder. Okay. So I'm just going to take some of that and I'm going to press it on top of this blue. Just give me a little sparkle. Give just a little bit of sparkle to the eye. A little bit more in the cap. And then I'm just going to take my finger like I did before and lightly blend it through. Okay, so the next thing I need is a transition color. And my transition color that I'm going to use is my Chanel. And it is called Sphinx. You guys see me use this before, I believe. I'm just going to take my Shadow Smudge brush from Sephora. And then I'm just going to lightly transition it right on the edges of the blue. You always need a transition color when you're doing a dark eye. Just like when you're doing a light eye, excuse me, like salute everyone. Just like when you're doing a light eye, you want a crease color. So with a dark eye, you want a transition. Just gonna get it in there. Okay, it's perfect. Next one I'm going to grab is another Mika Bella shadow. It's like a grayish shimmer, and it's called Ambivalence. Okay, put that in the cap. This I'm going to put right on the inner corners of the eye, right here. Just layer it on. And I'm going to bring it a little bit underneath the eye. Not totally through, but just a little bit through. Just about right there. A couple of inches. Okay? Perfect. Okay. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that blue from our Wet n Wild palette. And I'm going to just bring it underneath the eye. Bringing color underneath the eye, for those who don't know, it makes your color pop that much more. Sorry, I have to keep my mouth open. That's weird. But that's what I do. Okay. So over this up here, I'm going to go back over that color. I'm going to go into my Rimmel London. And I'm going to pick up this gray up here. If you can see that. It's a grayish color. Okay. Just going to pat it on. Okay. I'm just going to use my finger to blend. I'm going to go over my transition color once again. Okay. Perfect. Okay, just because I'm being lazy today, I don't feel like using my gel pot, so I'm going to use a quick one. And this is by Clean Color. It's a beauty supply quick liner I bought. Going to get our eyes going on head and lined up. I don't do a lot of dark colors on my lower lid, like a smoky eye or anything like that. I do it on clients, but for me personally, I never thought it looked good. So I'm going to start, and you know, I'm starting by doing these type of colors, like dark blues and purples and things like that first. Okay, so the mascaras that I'm going to be using today, because I don't have false eyelashes. I suck, I know, but it's fine. So what I'm going to be using is a combination of Voluminous Milia Lashes and Falsies. Okay. Seeing if I'm still recording because my camera is tripping. Perfect. Then going over that with the Falsies. Perfect. Next, eyebrows. Okay, so for my eyebrows, I like to use my eyebrow brush, of course. I've already had them plucked and arched, as much as I will let it be done.